Well, I know the Facebook post that I'm responding to right now was calling for pictures, but mine's too big to get in frame. I don't have enough space to get it all in frame at once. So we're gonna go through it the old-fashioned style via YouTube video done on a cell phone because my camera is out of battery and the sound sucks on it. But anyway, let's go through basically the entire thing. So there we've got my absolute atrocity. It's a Mega Magnus that's had some Turion parts stuck to it, including pieces of combs and a part. I think that was part of Centurion's bolt stuck into the screw post. I'm gonna have to re-glue that properly, or do a proper Magnus. There we've got a demolisher, which I currently have not attached anything to because I'm not doing any of that. That's my rival nemesis. I've got the rival battery pack inside it, and it's stock, nothing really too big with it. That's the mag strike. I really like the mag strike, and if you have more clips for it, I would really, really love to get a hold of them if I have the money for it. That is a technically it's called a hunter crossbow, but I always call it the bear toy crossbow because that's basically what it is. That's what the original one that I got my hands on was called. Basically, it'll shoot anything that you can throw into there. It can shoot megas, it can shoot elites or Accufakes, it can shoot Lego bricks, it can shoot friggin' AA batteries if you're crazy enough, shoot flashlights, you can shoot a lot of stuff out of there. And it never jams unless you're a complete tool with it. We got a Thunderbow, Regulator, another one of my favorite Nerf guns, alongside the Elite, alongside the Rival Nemesis. Then we've got a Hailfire. This is a good loner because it's semi-automatic, gives you a good amount of firepower, and you don't need a lot of gear to use it. You just stick eight magazines in it and you're good to go. This is my AK Auto Strifle. Yes, that's the entire name of it. Basically, it's a worker AK kit with the front of the with the Krinkov flash hider on the front painted orange. And then I'm running it off two Kolok batteries and two dummy batteries, and then I've got an auto strife kit, which I have the wires from it coming out of the where the sling port was, and then I've got it all hooked up onto the battery tray, and I've got the battery tray hot glued onto the stock. Then I've got my Gel Customs Creations Rapid Strike, which I converted into a pistol, stuck the battery tray on the side, added a worker stock, added a sling, and I added a $40 optic on there, red dot, cheap airsoft sight. It's pretty damn good. And the by the way, the rapid pistol conversion kit came from Blastersmiths UK, and I seem to have botched that up too. Then we've got a modulus, just standard modulus, nothing really to it. I did change the battery screw on it because the battery screw was a little weird. Now, you might be asking, why do you have two light commands? Well, the one without the battery tray, without any batteries in it, is fucked. Basically, the problem with it is when you turn it on and you tilt it at all, it starts squealing. This one doesn't. I got two of them because I wanted two belts, but we'll get into that. So we got a sledge fire, got a rough cut, bare bones stock with a stock attachment point attached to it because I just like having stocks. They just feel ergonomically better. We've got a tri-strike, of course. Then we got a long shot. This one's got an orange ModWorks kit in it and an upgraded, I think it's a 5 kg spring in it. Nothing too special, but down the line it's going to get even better. And of course, it got the front gun. Once we get the Omega kit in this and we get the 20 kg spring and the auto priming stock, we're just going to ditch that thing entirely. Probably sell it off for like $5 or something, the front gun. Got an XBZ because, gotta always have something to bust shields. Then we've got the Tri-Strike launcher, which I more or less use kind of as a mortar because really, when you can just fling shots constantly with a HAMP system, why wouldn't you? Sling fire, what's this thing called again? Not a Hailfire, it's a Hyperfire, yeah. Hyperfire with a muzzle attachment glued onto it because I wanted to attach barrels and I was kind of choked that this thing didn't include that ability out of the box. Stock, basically. Then we've got a retaliator. It's got the mediator barrel and stock on it because, ironically enough, it looks more organic with that on anyway. And besides, I kind of needed the space. So here we got a dart zone and we got a dart zone enforcer. Of course, gotta have a chain gun, because it's in the rules somewhere. Then we've got our terror scout. I don't use it very much because mine seems to be defective. And then we've got a barrel strike, one of the attachments in the modulators.
Hey, Doug, what do you want? What do you want? I'm trying to shoot a video here, Doug.
And then we've got a bunch of 18-round mags, because, of course, I have to have a bunch of 18-round mags. Got some 12s. Yes, those are 12s. A whole line of 6 clips. Yes, that's also a 6 clip, but it also goes with the Centurion, and mega darts are friggin' massive. A couple 10s, an 8, a 35-round drum. Got a light take, what they call them, claymore, is the directional mine. Of course, I've got the remote for the thing, I've got a light take grenade, the controller for that defective pile of crap. Then we got this mortar here, which actually does work like a mortar. You take one of those shells, you shove it in the loading tool, then you drop it into that and it shoots out. Now let me show you if I can do this one-handed. So I've got it in the loading tool here, pressed against my chest. Pull it out, and you'll drop it in the mortar, and you've got the light, two light command belts stuck together because, 40 is better than 20. I have a giant long Vulcan belt here, 75 rounds. Got a bunch of Worker 22 round mags because they're my freaking favorite. And of course, the light take electronic target. I still use it from time to time, but I really wish I could figure out what the hell it's saying. Then we've got some rockets for the demolisher and for that thing, the XBZ. Couple of these off-brand rockets, though. Yeah, I'm gonna have to re-glue these because they are pretty badly screwed. Here we got a bunch of pistols, and this is one of the dollar store Zing knockoff things. Basically, you stretch this and you use this kind of like archery. You pull it all the way back, and then you let it go, and then it goes flying and it screams through the air. I'll show you a demo later, maybe. Got a strong arm. This one has one basic mod, but no performance mods. Basically, I've taken out the dart pegs. Got a double strike, bone stock, mega cyclone shock, bone stock, one of these knockoff Chinese Desert Eagles, bone stock, Rival Kronos. I'm going to be modifying the crap out of this pretty quickly. That's a fire strike. It's got some mods on it. I think it's double springed. Falcon fire. It's got an upgraded, I think, 5 kilogram spring. Nerf hammer shot. Not a rival hammer shot, but a hammer shot. It's got the metal kit installed in it, and it's going to have an 8-round cylinder from Gavin Fuzzy installed in it in the future. Big shock, bone stock, an Australian spec given by the Grey Trigger. Jolt, everyone needs a jolt. One of these X-Shot micros, which are just a jolt. Then we got a triad, of course. These are some of the miscellaneous random darts, like Dart Zone Super Darts, Elite Darts, Modulus Darts, Nipple Tips, Busby Suctions, stuff like that. These are just random elite compatible darts that I have in there. I'm going to be cutting them down. Then we got a bunch of accessories. We've got a Raider stock, long strike barrel, because I got rid of my long strike, because I screwed it up horribly, apparently. We've got a, what's it called? A regulator barrel, got a modulus scope, a modulus barrel, long shot scope. Two Spectre stocks, one of them came from an EAT, one came from the actual Spectre, the Elite Spectre. Got the tri-strike front attachment. We got a couple of vertical grips, got a retaliator stock. Then we've got a regular old, well, we got a Nathaniel Deal ammo counter, a stock from the Demolisher AK kit, couple of barrels, couple sights, a rifle mask, stock, light, bayonet. And then over there, we've got a couple of melee options and some tactical gear. And in here, we got 4,000 darts.